Channel, Kirsten Erickson. Nothing in life is just sweet and pretty. Life is hard many times, life is a mess, a brutal collision between difficult feelings and more. Life is not only a beautiful smile and only happiness, nor only sunshine and blue skies and where there are no troublesome heartaches. It is very easy to buy into the perfect way of living, as if there would be a perfect life, with only happiness and no famine, no war, no hardships of any kind. The ideal life, what is that? The ideal life, is that a life where you never die? The ideal life, is that when you look young even if you are 90 years old? The perfect life, is that a life where you laugh and have fun all day long? Well, I must say I am sorry to break your magical dream here. Yes, you must have your dreams and your visions, of course. But the reality is, you are born into this life, and then you leave. And the time in between, the arrival and the departure, that is the time you are here. This is your very life, and it can be short or long. A perfect surface, many of you still search for it. It is becoming very common to do surgery to change the surface of your bodies. True happiness comes from the inside. No matter if your teeth or nose are crooked or no matter how your body looks like, true happiness resides within your heart. Your body is a microcosmos, and a piece of the entire universe because you are the universe, a part of it. There is no separation. It is okay, for example, to do surgery of your nose if you cannot breathe through it. And the same goes for the entire body, if you really need help to make it function well. I don't say anything. And you might say it is a choice. And yes, it is. If you have a bottom that you think is too small and you want a really big bottom, then you can have it. Just doing the surgery? Oh yes, but God don't think it is necessary. God thinks your bottom is okay as it is. It is God that is the creator. You are an image of God. God says, what is it that you really are searching for? Changing your bodies can actually be a sorrow in disguise. It starts with makeup. Showing less and less of yourself, and who you really are. Showing a face that is not yours entirely. Please just be you, exactly as you are. I love you as you are and you don't need to change to please me, says God. But if you are sad, be sad. Don't hide it. If you feel sorrow, feel it. Don't hide your feelings. Don't hide yourself. Hiding behind a perfect makeup, and not allowing your true feelings to surface? Please take your feelings seriously, because I do. I listen to what you feel, and what you want to express, for I love you. Some makes money on this, and many times there are painful experiments on animals in laboratories, for cosmetics, and more. What whip does this give? Pain and assault of animals to look different? In a culture where hiding your feelings and how you truly look is custom, please be proud of every wrinkle and of every tear you shed. Makeup has been worn by many for thousands of years, both females and males used it. And this need to change, this need to appear different, started a long time ago. I see directly into your heart and for me all this change is not necessary. But if you think it is important, it is your choice. Taking a bath. Combing your hair. Brushing your teeth. Putting on clean and whole clothes, that you feel is comfortable, this is a positive platform to begin from. Feeling beautiful comes from being at peace within, in your heart. Daily healing rituals, lovely morning routines, is something I gladly teach you if you are interested, just let me know. I love you. Beautiful as you are, Mate Raya.